in every age. Wouldn't you like to see something strange? Come with us and you will see.
Hey guys, welcome back to chapter 28, The Sickness of the Mind, of David Walliams, The Beast of Buckingham Palace. Remember to pay close attention. Do not put, I don't know. Go back and rewatch if you missed the answer, because these are pretty short chapters. Let's get started with chapter 28, Sickness of the Mind. Lionheart? Asked a voice from above. Alfred wanted to be strong, but it was impossible. Immediately he burst into floods of tears. Woo-hoo! Shh, shushed the queen through the hole in the ceiling of the cell. The guards will hear you. I can't help it, snorted Alfred. Don't be sad, she whispered. I'm not crying because I'm sad. I'm crying because I'm happy. Happy? Happy to see you. Now you're going to make me cry, replied the boy's mother. Here. The queen pushed a lace handkerchief down through the hole. Alfred took it and dried his eyes. Then he blew his nose. Whew! He studied the handkerchief for a moment and read the letter sewn in the corner. V.R. Victoria Regina. That's Queen Victoria. So this handkerchief is hundreds of years old. Yes, I shouldn't really be letting you snot into it. Sorry. Do you want it back? Well, that's awfully kind of you, but no. What should I do with it? Pop it up your sleeve. The boy did as he was told and pushed it into his sleeve of his pajamas. The handkerchief felt all soggy next to his skin, and for a moment he wondered why grown-ups would ever do that. Mama, how I wish I could have one of your special cuddles right now. Oh, how I wish I could give you a special cuddle. I would give you all my past and all my future to hold you in my arms right now. You're going to make me cry again, he sniffled. Alfred, let's have a finger cuddle. A finger cuddle? Yes. Here you go. With that, the queen poked her finger down through the hole. Alfred stretched high on his bucket and poked his finger up. They touched. It felt strange and strangely comforting all at once. Why have you been sent here? Asked the queen. Father sent me. No! How could he do that to his own son? He's not well, Mama. You're right. There's an awful sickness in his mind. He would tell me about these terrifying nightmares, night after night after night. Nightmares about some kind of fiery monster. They're not nightmares, Mama, replied Alfred. They're real. What on earth do you mean? You're not going to believe me, but I saw something in the palace during the night. Something truly horrifying. What? The king was there. What was he doing? It looked like he was sleepwalking. Sleepwalking? Yes, into this, well, I can't exactly... Ritual. Ritual? Was it just your father? No, the Lord Protector was there. Of course, I should have guessed he would be behind it, exclaimed Mother. Yes, using some dark arts. The Lord Protector was... He was what? The boy felt strange saying it, but he knew what he had seen. Conjuring a creature to life. What kind of creature? A creature made of fire. A griffin. A griffin? Pondered his mother. The symbol of divine power dating back thousands of years? Are you sure you weren't just reading one of your old books and having a nightmare? No, replied Alfred calmly. This was real. Then the griffin must give the Lord Protector power over the king. The visions must have scared him half to death. Poor, poor man. But it isn't just a vision, Mama. And if we don't stop it, this beast will kill us all. That does it for chapter 28, The Beast of Buckingham Palace. Use those complete sentences in answering your questions. Restate the question. And have a great rest of your day. See you tomorrow, guys.